Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, in the morning sky, about an hour and a half or two before sunrise, we've got this beautiful sight towards the south. Jupiter is on one side of the Milky Way, Saturn is on the other side of the Milky Way. If you happen to have a telescope out at that time of the morning, definitely check these out. This is a beautiful sight to be able to see. However, what I want to point out to you is something a little different that we can see naked eye, maybe, but more than likely you may need some binoculars and definitely a very flat eastern horizon. If we skip ahead about 1 hour, we can see how Venus is down here on April 8th, and Mercury is just above the horizon there. I'm going to zoom in on these a little bit. And you can see how low Mercury is because if I go forward in time, even just a little bit, the sun gets higher. We start to lose the planet by about 6 o'clock in the morning. So you have a very short window to be able to see this. However, there's two other things that are kind of against us in this regard. One is that if you look at where the ecliptic runs at this time of the year, you can see that both of these planets are below it. So that means that rather than being on the other side of it, which would put them up higher, just based on how orbital things work and tilts of orbits and things like that, Mercury and Venus happen to be below the ecliptic right now. So that's going to make them a little more difficult to see. The other thing is that just the way, because of the angle of the ecliptic, it's so low to the ground. Instead of being up like it very often is, say, in 6 months from now, when it'll be kind of aiming much more upward. At this time of the morning in the spring, it's got this really low angle to it, so that doesn't help. If we bring up the planet orbits, you can even see for Mercury just how low that's going to go. It's not going to go, jump way up like this. It's going along that ecliptic line, unfortunately. However, there is an opportunity here because pulling up our measuring tool, we can see that if we go from Mercury to Venus, we've got just about 5 degrees, maybe 6 degrees between them. So most binoculars that have a 7 degree field of view are going to be able to see both of these. So Venus, obviously being much brighter, we've got this nice beacon nearby to help us find where Mercury's at. Mercury's just going to be a little bit down below where Venus is at. So that is maybe half of a binocular field of view, and then when you go over, you're going to be almost a full binocular field of view if you kind of do the right angle triangle here, using the horizon as your guide. Or you can just angle down that way and estimate it using just some mental geometry. So if we, but there's actually a little bit more happening here, and I'm going to turn off this, and I will kind of zoom in on Mercury. I'm going to back up time-wise. Whoops, too far. I'm going to back up time-wise just a little bit and see if I can grab some stars in here to sort of center this. You can see there's Neptune. And if we go forward in time, we wind up almost with all three. We can actually get Venus right next to where Neptune is at on the morning of the 10th. I don't know if you're going to be able to see Neptune. Neptune is eighth magnitude. So that's going to be a tough one. I'm sorry, Neptune is actually right there. So there we go. 7.95, effectively eighth magnitude. Good luck with that. Possible, but if you see it, let me know. Shoot me a message either on Twitter or on Facebook, or leave me a message here on YouTube and let me know that you saw Neptune with binoculars. That would be pretty cool. And if you actually use a telescope that direction with enough aperture, you might be able to see those two planets together on the morning of the 10th. You might even be able to get it on the 11th to 12th, but you'd have to have a pretty wide field of view. On the 9th, it's more possible just because they're going to be closer together. If we go forward in time a little bit more, we can see how Venus and Mercury, see, there's that field of view where you can actually have all three planets, but more than likely you'll see Venus and Mercury together. And those will kind of track the same way. If we take the binoculars off and zoom out and just look at where Mercury is relative to Venus, and we go forward, you can see how really through the 14th. Now, as you'll notice, as I go forward in time like this, the sky is getting lighter. So that means we need to back up a little bit. I'm going to suggest that you start looking about a half hour before your local sunrise. That's probably going to be your best opportunity because check out how, and this is the third thing, I guess, actually, that is the issue, is look at how low these are to the horizon. Mercury's only 2.5 degrees up there. What's our distance here of altitude? Yeah, 2.2. That's not very high. We can go forward a couple minutes and get it at like almost 3 degrees high. The lowest I've ever seen Mercury is about 3 degrees off the horizon. It's not easy to do. You're looking through a lot of atmosphere at that point, but it's possible. Again, binoculars are definitely going to help you here, and you have Venus as your guide. So Venus being really bright at negative almost 4, you should not have any issue seeing that. I do want to show you one other thing that's going to be the reason why Venus is not with us really much higher than this. Watch what happens when I go forward in time. Actually, let me take off this. And we'll take away the ecliptic because we don't need to necessarily. Actually, I'll leave the ecliptic up because we can see kind of what's happening here. I'm going to back out just a little bit and watch what happens with Venus as we go forward in time. It just kind of stays there. I got to back up and keep things a little bit dark. But even as we go forward through the months, look at how Venus is just sitting there. It's not dropping towards the sun. It's just kind of hugging the horizon, moving towards the north. Look at that. Just sitting there, not doing it. I actually can go all the way forward into just about the middle of July here. That's when, look at how the ecliptic, it was so low before, and you watch a late part of June into July, how it goes whoop and gets really steep. That's also when Venus is heading towards the sun. And we'll come out of our field of vision and we'll wind up being in the evening about a month or two later. But that's kind of interesting with Venus too. But definitely look for Mercury this week in the morning, perhaps as late as next weekend. Definitely a cool sight to be able to see and maybe Neptune with it. Let me know if you capture that with all three in the same field of view. That would be a pretty cool thing to view. That is all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.